Under the course MBA 200, it is Advanced Business Research. So for topic 1, we will be discussing about the introduction to advanced business research. So this will be the topic outline for today. First, we will be introducing what the topic will be all about. Second, we will also talk about the research or research in business administration. Third, we will be discussing the different types of business research. And lastly, we will also talk about the ethical considerations that exist in business research. So, as an introduction, let us first answer the question, what is research? So, ano nga ba ang research? What is research? Why is it there? Why does it exist? So, basically, the term research originates from the French word rechercher, which translates to go about seeking. It basically entails the systematic exploration and collection of factual information, typically aimed at addressing various issues or specific inquiries. In essence, research can be defined as a systematic and scientific approach to inquiry and investigation. So let's proceed to the next. Research in business administration. Business research serves as a valuable tool for managerial decision making, since it involves the collection of and analysis of data obtained through systematic inquiries. The numerous approaches encompassing planning, collecting, analysis, and dissemination of essential data, insights, and information enable organizations to effectively mobilize their management and undertake critical measures to optimize performance. Okay, so let's talk about the scope of business research. So we have the first one, business environment. So the business environment encompasses several internal and external factors that can influence marketing efforts. The internal environment of a company might encompass factors such as pricing strategies, advertising efforts, and product distribution methods. The external environment encompasses as well several factors such as economic, societal, political, legal, and governmental aspects. So for the second one, we have the consumption pattern. The evaluation of consumption patterns is overseen by the management. When conducting research, it is crucial to examine the behavioral patterns, attitudes, and purchasing capabilities of consumers. The purchasing power of consumers is often determined primarily by their disposable personal income. Consequently, the assessment of a country or geographical area's total purchasing power is contingent upon the disposable income of its residents. The determinants influencing the consumption patterns can be discovered by empirical investigation. So for the third one, we have controlling. Control is a crucial aspect of management as it allows for the identification of flaws and shortcomings in decision-making processes. In order to effectively address these issues and realign planning and performance strategies, research is employed as a control strategy by management. So we have the next set of scope under business research. So we have decision making. Researchers offer significant information and data that have been carefully examined and analyzed, enabling informed decision making across several business domains. This is particularly advantageous for managerial decision making. The proliferation of technology, increased productivity, and growing market complexities have underscored the need of research as an essential tool for making informed decisions. So for finance, research in finance provides help to specialists and individuals engaged in the study of financial industry, particularly in relation to the impact of market fluctuations and trends. The primary focus is on the assessment of financial needs, the management of financial resources, judgments about capital structure, the selection of financing resources, the determination of investment patterns, effective cash management, the implementation of financial controls, and the prudent utilization of surplus funds. And then we have the sixth one, growing complex markets. The expansion of intricate markets is closely intertwined with the typical lifestyles of customers and the advancements in science and technology. The presence of several retailers in the varying size and specializations within the business unit have resulted in a significant communication gap between manufacturers and customers. The widening disparity between consumers and producers underscores the need for scholarly investigation in the field of marketing to address the communication gap. So for human resource management, it encompasses a comprehensive comprehension of effective and ineffective practices, the necessity for modifications, and the nature and extent of such adjustments. The field of human resource aims to investigate the fundamental connections that can lead to improved decision-making regarding personal matters, including turnover, absenteeism, compensation levels and structure, job satisfaction, employee morale, managerial potential assessment, training effectiveness, grievance handling, labor relations, and collective bargaining. So for management planning, this is a process that heavily relies on the utilization of research. This statement pertains to the exploration and utilization of business prospects, especially those that are deemed viable for exploitation by managerial entities. Hence, the management has the ability to evaluate the resources that are beneficial for the firm. We also have marketing strategy. This is a crucial aspect of management that entails the implementation of appropriate strategies to effectively address competition, pursue market expansion, and achieve organizational objectives. By conducting through research or thorough research rather, it is possible to develop effective programs and recommendations pertaining to pricing, distribution, sales promotion, product development, and other related aspects. So for the last set of scope under business research, we have problem solving. Problem solving is a crucial research activity that involves identifying problems, formulating alternative solutions, and assessing these options within different management domains. In the context of business fundamentals, it is essential to make judgments that pertain to both short-term and long-term objectives, which constitutes the central focus of problem-solving research. Lastly, we have production management. Production management involves utilizing research to facilitate efficient production by enabling producers to make informed decisions that align with the available production resources and cater to emerging market demands. The research effectively assesses the market opportunities and production resources. Research plays a crucial role in various significant tasks such as product creation, diversification, introduction of new items, product enhancement, technological processes, site selection, and new investments. Okay, now let's proceed to the types of business research. We have exploratory research, casual research, descriptive research, and predictive research. So let's talk about exploratory research. Exploratory research is alternatively referred to as formulative research, as its primary objective is to gather preliminary information that aids in the identification of problems and the formulation of hypothesis recommendations. The primary contribution of exploratory research lies not in its direct influence on decision-making processes, but rather in its potential to offer significant insights for a specific context. So for descriptive research, this encompasses the investigation of various phenomena through the utilization of surveys and fact-finding techniques. This methodology, commonly referred to as statistical research, facilitates the comprehensive depiction of data and the inherent attributions pertaining to the observed phenomenon under investigation. The descriptive form of research typically addresses inquiries pertaining to the identification of who, when, where, what, and how. So we have casual research. In contrast to descriptive research, casual research endeavors to establish a cause and effect relationship between two variables. This form of research is often employed in the fields of physics, chemistry, biology, and medicine. This facilitates the execution of market evaluations, enhances internal procedures, and promotes the development of more successful business plans. And lastly, we have predictive research. The primary focus of this inquiry pertains to the anticipation of results, expenditures, impacts, or ramifications. Essentially, it entails the formulation of informed conjectures or assessments concerning forthcoming occurrences or consequences which are based on accessible data and information. This discourse mostly revolves around hypothetical, theoretical, and experimental concepts encompassing ideas that have not undergone empirical testing and may lack testability or have not previously existed. Now let's talk about the ethical considerations in business research. So first, let us talk about what is ethics. So ethics is basically, it refers to the established rules and principles that govern an individual's conduct and moral decision-making in respect to their interaction with others. Ethics can be understood as an individual's code of conduct, which is founded upon principles of respect towards oneself, one's peers, and the surrounding environment. So we have four ethical considerations. We have under data management, reciprocity and trust, copyright, affiliation, and conflicts of interest. So let's tackle them one by one. So we have data management. The regular collection, preservation, and exchange of digital data give rise to novel concerns regarding the protection and of sensitive information and ethical quandaries. The central focus of this discussion revolves around the ownership of data and the circumstances under which individuals are granted permission to utilize it. It is imperative to clearly articulate the aims for long-term preservation and sharing when obtaining informed consent from participants in a study. Therefore, these decisions must be established from the outset of a project. So we also have copyright. So the matter of copyright is also influenced by legal considerations. The legal concept of copyright serves as a means of protecting the rights of the copyright holder by preventing illegal reproduction. Copyright rules protect a wide range of scholarly materials, including research papers, books, journals, and raw data such as spreadsheets and interview transcripts. Reciprocity and trust in various other circumstances, it has been argued that ethical principles increasingly prioritize the importance of honesty and openness in disseminating information regarding a study to all relevant stakeholders. This perspective promotes the idea of a mutually beneficial research, and participants acknowledge each other as moral agents and adhere to a predefined set of moral standards. And lastly, we have affiliation and conflicts of interest. Within the realm of scientific inquiry, it is well acknowledged that affiliations, particularly those pertaining to financial support, possesses the capacity to exert influence over the manner in which research topics are delineated and outcomes are communicated. It should be noted that the presence of bias in a given context does not necessarily imply inherent bias. Rather, bias may be subjectively perceived, particularly by the media, leading to potential discreditation of the information. Alright, so that's the end of our topic for today. I hope you learned something, and I'll see you guys next time.